friends, my name is Beck, and today we are back playing What Remains of Edith Finch. When we left off, we learned the fates of Greg and Gus Dawn, so her uncles, who both died when they were really little, when they were little boys. And we found out where Dawn met Sanjay, who is Edith's mom.
My mom moved to India a week after graduation and got a job teaching English. Lewis was born a year later.
Oh, look, there's Milton stuff. Wow, they got busy. Oh my gosh, this is so dangerous. We're going up, up, up.
When my dad died, I don't think Mom knew where else to go. I'm sure Edie was happy to have her back.
Lewis, Milton, Edith. Wow, these just stayed dead.
And to see kids in the house again.
Yeah, it's like life. Aw. This is so sad.
The house had to get a little bigger, but Edie was used to that.
Always building new parts of the house.
And for a while, things were good. Almost normal.
Did they do homeschool? Gus, Sven, Barbara, Molly, Sam, Calvin. Lewis rules. Fact or fiction, our family history. That's so cute.
But it didn't last.
Scientific method, observation, question, research, hypothesis, experiment, data, and conclusion. This system of understanding everything is super useful to apply not only to, like, science, obviously, but also to, like, literary analysis and, like, reviewing a game or something. Like, if you just apply this set of seven things to the world, you will be good. You'll be good. The best way to learn things, I think. Relief efforts end in disaster. Aww. That's when Sanjay died, that must have been. Because that's a picture of him.
Beginning of the end was Milton's 10th birthday.
Milton.
When Edie gave him a castle.
Oh. Is this the top of the house? I mean, obviously, but, like, it goes up a lot.
After Milton disappeared, the only thing he left behind was a room full of paintings.
So, I want to see what's around here, though. Probably nothing, but just in case, you never know. Correct. Nothing. And don't want me to go this way anyway, because there are plastic bags there. Man, this place is kind of creepy. Beautiful. Oh no, it still goes up, up, up. Wow. Look at all this paint everywhere. So, basically, I guess everyone is accepting that he's dead. Aww.
I think Edie was happy to finally have another painter in the family.
Oh. Wow. And he's like a little builder, too? Making up these like places and worlds and things and practicing sketching. These castles. Oh my gosh. This is awesome. You are a pregnant lady. This makes me so sad! Let's go back down. Oh my gosh. So do they practically live up here?
Milton Finch in The Magic Paintbrush.
Thank you. This kid is awesome. Oh, it's the giant foot. It's a door. It's the magical door that he painted. That's where he vanished to. He vanished through the door.
I was four when Alton disappeared.
Four. 4 years old. Ooh, they should not have moved back to that house. Milton. 1992? That's the year I was born. What the heck is happening? Thank you. My phone saw. I went to take the time and my phone was just not doing anything. Okay, let's go down.
Mom spent months searching for my brother. Then she sealed the doors.
That's so sad. Then she started sealing the doors. It was driving her crazy. It's a magic door. He told you he's through there.
Whatever Milton had found in the house, Mom didn't want it getting out.
What did he find? What secret had he discovered? This is not up to code. I'm just 100% guaranteeing you right this moment. Can I please get through? Thank you. I know I'm 22 weeks
Mom
pregnant.
Mom definitely blamed Edie, but...
And therefore giant,
Lewis
but...
blamed himself.
Blamed himself? What did he do, though? Nothing!
After he graduated, he just spent more and more time in his room. Until Mom got him a job at the cannery.
Oh, Lewis blamed himself for it.
Everyone always told me to stay out of Lewis's room.
No,
except
no.
Lewis.
Oh, I can't look around. Oh, we got some. 420 blazing happening in there! What? Lewis. Lou, can I go this way? Let's go into Lou's room. Yeah, he was definitely, like, what, why else would you have those nice rocking chairs on a boat? I mean, on a boat in a tree. Gosh, yeah, she's getting more and more tired.
Lewis's room smelled very, very familiar.
Oh.
That part of him lived on.
So you're saying it smelled like weed? What? Stop! All I did was turn around. I didn't do anything. Stop. No. Go back inside, please. This game. Bam, bam, bam. Yes.
Lewis and I spent a lot of time playing games together, but he was surprisingly bad at them. He died a lot.
Oh, there's a TV. Don Finch.
Dear Mrs. Finch, as Lewis's psychiatrist, I can understand your desire for an explanation. As I see it, the trouble began in January, shortly after we convinced your son to seek treatment for substance abuse. Newly sober, I believe Lewis first noticed the monotony of his daily life. He kept working at the cannery. But he withdrew part of himself. In our sessions, I saw the same behavior. His mind began to... wander. I asked him to describe it.
This is so hard.
He said he started small, imagining a labyrinth.
Oh, man.
He'd feel his way about. Then something moved. Bats. And toads.
Oh.
things that have not names.
It's kind of hard.
He knew it was all in his head. But he took it very seriously. I had hoped
he'd find himself. I'm so focused. Stuff is getting in the way. Oops. It's hard. Get out of here, dude.
But he found something more.
What?
I worried about him then. Daydreaming at the cannery. I spoke with his boss. But he said Lewis had become a model employee. Methodical, tireless, focused.
I would daydream at the cannery.
Like a whole new Lewis. So I let him go on.
Sorry.
I even encouraged him.
Hmm.
It seemed very promising at first. He told me he'd made a new friend.
Hello, puppy.
On the edge of a city he named Lewis Topia. He built the city up slowly, brick by brick.
Huh.
Then he made musicians.
This is awesome. Go.
And songs for them to play.
This is so awesome!
He talked about starting a band. And he was always humming.
Can I go in there? No, okay. This is awesome.
Every day his imagination grew stronger.
Yeah, it did.
He no longer spoke at the cannery.
Oh, and the sounds of the stuff is getting quieter. The sounds of the chopping machine.
But his chopping was as reliable as ever.
Yeah, dude. This is
awesome.
Then
one day it struck him. At all the cheering crowds, even the stones under his feet, were all in his imagination. So he could do whatever he wished. He held an
election. This is awesome.
And he won.
Of course, dude.
They begged him to stay, but his mind was already wandering. It became a game for him.
Oh.
He'd conquer a city, then immediately push on. New Lewisville.
Yes. That one I don't think got its head cut off.
St. Louis.
St. Louis. Well.
He started drifting away from our reality. Minneapolis.
Minneapolis.
Until
that's
one
awesome.
Day he forgot to go home from the cannery. Even as his mother pleaded with him, part of Lewis kept sailing on.
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh.
In Lewisburg, he heard rumors of a...
Of a... What? I got so confused. A handsome queen.
Handsome queen.
It's like beautiful and handsome. Oh, she's lovely. Oh. Oh, what's gonna happen in his imagination here, dude.
The queen was on her own quest for...
For radiant... Sinister serpent seems cooler, though, dude. I'm backing up.
Radiant.
No! No choice now. I made the choice too late. Oh well. Such radiant rainbows. I'm sorry, I'm knocking over the radiant rainbows, dude.
He followed the sound of her.
Of her silver harp!
Silver
harp. Oh, I should have chosen the- I thought it's an electric guitar, not electric sitar, even though I was like, that doesn't look like it's a guitar.
His chase led him to a golden palace east of the sun and west of the moon.
Oh my gosh, this is the best.
Even then, his logic remained sound.
This is so good. This is long, though, dude.
He knew the world was all in his imagination.
Come on.
But he was so proud of having created it. In his own eyes, he'd become something greater than a king.
Hmm. At least he's somewhat paying attention to this
stuff. For someone who'd never known success in the real world, I think it was overwhelming.
Hmm.
And then it struck him that the real Lewis was not the one chopping salmon, but the one climbing the steps of a golden palace.
This is crazy.
My imagination is as real as my body, he told me. It was hard to argue with him.
Uh-oh. Oh, there's his locker. Okay.
Began to forget the world we know.
Yikes. Why? This mouse is like giving me so many issues today. Oh, dang, dude.
I think it pained him to remember Lewis, the cannery worker.
Hmm. Oh my gosh. What happened? Oh.
He began to despise the man with a royal contempt.
Hmm. No. Look, he's not even doing anything. Okay, then what? Oh! Of course I am escalating. I'm going up to my castle.
Even after he said he was being crowned king over all the lands of wonder.
Oh, wow. He's like just delusional.
The palace would be packed with his companions.
Oh. This is beautiful. This is so fun. I mean, it's very sad. I'm very sad, but...
Including the wise Calico and insisted on advising him.
Wise Calico? Oh, I'm not even controlling it. I thought holding it down is helping me go faster, but no. They're all so happy! No, I'm going. Uh-oh, I'm afraid.
His queen waited, holding his crown.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh. music is very loud. Left to do. Oh no, the crown! What is a crown? Is a crown the guillotine thing? Oh my gosh, I knew it.
I think you know. Mrs. Finch, your son was a kind man who will be missed by all of us who knew him.
Oh. Oh my gosh. Oh.
My brother was really cool. I wish you could have met him.
Oh. I'm sure he's really cool. However, friends, this is where I'm going to end it for today. Thank you all so much for watching. I hope that you enjoyed it. If you did, please let me know that you did. And, oh my gosh. You guys! You guys! I'll yell away from the microphone. It makes this just like... Everything just gets sadder and sadder. Ugh. Ugh. Man. Well, you know, I hope that you had a good time watching this. If you really liked it, then you are more than welcome to subscribe. I post new videos every Monday through Saturday, so there's plenty of new stuff for you to stop by and check out. And I hope you guys are having a great day. And don't get too lost in your imagination, okay? Okay? Okay. Anyway,